ओके, नाउ वी विल सी वन न्यूमेरिकल रिगार्डिंग लोड बैलेंसिंग कॉन्सेप्ट. ओके, टेक अ प्री स्ट्रेसिंग मेंबर ऑफ ए बीम साइज ऑफ 150 बाय 300. ओके, इज यूज ओवर अ स्पैन ऑफ 10 मीटर. ही हैज गिवन लेंथ इक्वल्स टू 10 मीटर. The cable with eccentricity, zero eccentricity at this support, E at support is zero and linearly varying to 50 mm at this center. Okay, at center it is 50 mm. Okay, linearly varying to 50 mm at this center, carrying an concentric load of Q. Okay. Located at the center of the span, for the condition at the center of the span of this section, if the load counteracts the bending effect of pre-stressing force. Okay, just draw the diagram according to the given thing. Okay, this is your beam. Okay, this is 10 meter. Okay, now he says that zero eccentricity at this support. First I will draw the CG. Okay, this is that zero eccentricity at this center and sorry at the support and 50 mm center eccentricity at the center. Just draw as per the given things. Okay, here the eccentricity is 50 mm. Okay, and he says that there is a load acting Q at the center of the span. It is a point load. Okay, now what you should do, just to calculate the value of Q, you should find what is the value of Q such that the stresses will be zero. Now here the value of P, okay, here the value of P he has given as 500 kilonewton. Okay, now we know the formula FC equals to P upon A plus P into E upon Z minus mg upon Z minus mq upon z. Okay, now first find the value of a. A is nothing but 150 upon 300, that is 150 multiplied by 300, which is equals to 45,000 mm square. Okay, how we will calculate the z? It is rectangle, therefore BD square by 6. Substitute the value of B, that is 150 multiplied by D, it is 300. Okay, divided by 6, which is equals to 2.25 10 power 6 mm cube. Okay, now we need mg. Mg it is given by WL square upon 8. Because UDL is self load, sorry, here we are calculating of dead load. Dead load it will be uniformly distributed. Okay, but we need the value of W. This implies mg W, it can be calculated as 0.3 multiplied by 0.15. density you can take 24. Okay, here L he has given as 10. Okay, take it as 10 square upon 8. On calculation you will get 13.5 kilonewton meter. Okay, now you need the value of mq. Its value is q l into divided by 4. You know this is WL by 4, how we have got. Okay, if you draw the free body diagram, okay, basics okay, this is Q. The reactions will be Q by 2, Q by 2. This is L by 2, L by 2. If you take the moment about this point, it will be Q by 2 multiplied by L by 2, which will be Q into L upon 4. The same thing I have written here. Okay. Here we need the value of, we have to find out the value of Q. So keep as it is. Now substitute everything in this formula. Okay. That is Fc equals to 0. As he says that the stresses will be, it will counteract. Okay. Means the stress will be 0 equals to P value it is 500 10 power 3. Okay. Divided by area, it is 45,000. Okay. Plus 500 into 10 power 3. Eccentricity is 50. We are taking at this center. Okay. We are calculating at this center, not at the support. Okay. If we ask at the support, then here eccentricity value will be 0. Okay. Keep it in mind. At the center, 500. Okay. The eccentricity is 50 mm. Divided by the z value, it is 2.25 into 10 power 6 minus mg, we have got 13.5, okay, 10 power 6 divided by z, it is 2.25 into 10 power 6 minus q into l upon 4 divided by 2.25 into 10 power 6. Okay, this 0 equals to, simplify, you will get 11.11. this also you will get 11.11 minus 6 minus C here, Q, you know the value of L, put in terms of mm. Okay, divided by 4 into 2.25 into 10 power 6. Okay, 0 equals to, on simplification you will get Q equals to 14.61 kilonewton. Okay, this is how we will solve using the load balancing concept. The thing is that you should carefully see whether he is asking for load balancing concept, means indirectly he is asking it counteracts the bending effect of a pre-stressing force, or and just check whether which type of load he has given, whether it is point load or eccentric load or UDL. Okay, depending upon that one. Okay, similarly we will see another problem also, second one. Here the question is that a rectangular concrete, okay, beam of size, he has given beam size of 300 by 800, okay. D supports two concentrated load, okay, two concentrated load of 20 kilonewton each at 1/3 point of span of 9 meter. Suggest a suitable cable profile if eccentricity of the cable profile is 100 mm for the middle third portion of the beam. Okay, calculate the pre-stressing force required for the balance the bending effect of concentrated load. For the same cable profile, find the effective force in the cable if the resultant stress due to self-weight, imposed load and stressing load is 0. Okay, at the bottom fiber of, and he says at the bottom, okay, is 0 at the bottom fiber of the mid span section. Take density equals to 24 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay, draw the diagram as he has given. Okay, if you draw a longitudinal cross section, longitudinal section, here he says 20 kilonewton. Okay, it is 20 kilonewton. Okay, ओके एंड फॉर एवरी वन थर्ड टोटल स्पैन इज 9 मीटर, वन थर्ड ऑफ 9 इट विल बी 3 मीटर, टू थर्ड 3 मीटर, 3 मीटर, ओके एंड द सजेस्टेड केबल प्रोफाइल इज बाय सीइंग दिस इट विल बी अ ट्रेपेजॉइडल, ओके जस्ट ड्रॉ द डायग्राम यू विल कम टू नो, ओके हियर, ओके द केबल प्रोफाइल इट शुड बी लाइक दिस, सी बाय सीइंग द लोड द केबल प्रोफाइल इट शुड बी लाइक दिस एंड एक्सेंट्रिसिटी एज सेंटर ही हैज गिवन 100 mm, ओके नाउ व्हाट यू शुड डू जस्ट कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए, हियर इट इज 300 बाय 800, ओके 300 इंटू 800 इट विल गिव यू 24000 mm², ओके एक्सेंट्रिसिटी इट इज 100 mm, जेड वैल्यू इट विल बी बी डी स्क्वेयर अपॉन 6, बी वैल्यू विल बी 300 इंटू 800 स्क्वेयर अपॉन 6 विच इज इक्वल्स टू 3.2 इंटू 10^7 mm³, ओके नाउ कैलकुलेट द सेल्फ वेट इट इज गिवन बाय 0.3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.8 डेंसिटी ही सेड एज टेक इट एज 24 विच विल गिव 5.76 किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर, ओके नाउ यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द विच वन लाइव, ओके एम जी एंड एम क्यू, एम जी इट इज गिवन बाय डब्ल्यू एल स्क्वेयर अपॉन 8 विच इज इक्वल्स टू डब्ल्यू जी इंटू एल स्क्वेयर अपॉन 8 इट इज 5.76 इंटू एल वैल्यू इट इज 9 स्क्वेयर अपॉन 8 विच यू विल गेट 58.32 किलो न्यूटन मीटर. Now you should calculate the movement at the center of this span. Okay, see here. This is the center of this span. Okay, first calculate the reactions. Reactions it will be 20 kilo Newton. It will be 20 kilo Newton. This will be 20 kilo Newton. Okay, take the movement at the center of this span. Okay, first one. 20 into this distance is 4.5, okay this will be 1.5, this will be 1.5, okay here I am taking anti-clockwise as positive and clockwise as positive. 20 into perpendicular distance is 4.5, therefore I will write 20 into 4.5, okay and clockwise I am taking as positive minus 20 into this distance is 1.5, 20 into 1.5, okay, which will, it will give 60 kilo Newton meter, okay. Now here, he is asking to find the value of P, okay. In previous problem, he has given the value of Q. He was asking the value of Q, but here he has given the value of Q and he is asking the value of P here. Therefore, we have the formula. He says that the bottommost fiber stress is 0. Okay. We know the formula that FC equals to or FB equals to P upon A plus P into E upon ZB minus MG upon ZB minus MQ upon ZB. Okay. Here it is 0. Okay. P value we should find out. A value it is 300 into 800, okay, plus P value we should find out. At the center the eccentricity is 100 divided by the Z value it is 3.2 into 10^7, okay, minus MG value we have got 58.32 into 10^6 divided by Z value it is 3.2 into 10^7. माइनस एम क्यू वैल्यू इट इज 60 इंटू 10 पावर 6 डिवाइडेड बाय 3.2 इंटू 10 पावर 7। ओके, इन कैलकुलेटर यू कैन डायरेक्टली सब्सटीट्यूट ऑल दिस वैल्यू एंड यू कैन सॉल्व, यू विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ पी एज 507 किलो न्यूटन। ओके, दिस इज हाउ वी विल फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ पी बाई यूजिंग लोड बैलेंसिंग कॉन्सेप्ट। ओके, एंड ट्राई टू सॉल्व अदर टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल्स, इफ यू फाइंड एनी डिफिकल्टीज यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट मी।